A report surfaced yesterday that Cam Newton is fully aware that the starting quarterback position in New England is not his and that there will be an open competition for the job. Cam also reportedly understands that it might be difficult to get up to speed with a short-ended offseason. Now, Shannon, should Cam be upset and how should he feel about this open competition?
Skip, he knew what the deal was when he signed with the Patriots. Bill Belichick, nothing is promised with him. And the mere fact that he had a one-year deal told Cam that he was going to have to win this job. It wasn't going to be given to him. Teddy Bridgewater is the starter in Carolina. You know how we know, Skip? They gave him 3 years, $66 million. That's how you know you're the starter. Tom Brady is the starter in Tampa. You know how I know, Skip? They gave him 2 years, $50 million, fully guaranteed. Cam Newton got 1.75 with 550 guaranteed. So, in other words, you're in a dogfight. You win the job, you start. If not, you hold a clipboard until deemed necessary. That's just the way it works in New England, Skip. You don't get promised. You don't get promised anything. He makes it a competition. He doesn't want you to rest on your laurels. Well, I got this thing made. You know, I can sit back and, you know, fat cat. Now, you're not fat catting on Bill Belichick dying. He will get you up out of there.
And he paid you like a dime.
Yeah, exactly. So he won't even let you the fat cat skip, but he gave you chicken feet.
He did.
So that's just the way it is. I think Cam understands that. Cam understands he's going to have to go in there. He's going to have to work his tail off, and he's going to have to earn this job, which I believe Cam Newton will. But I don't think Cam is surprised by anything that's going on in New England. I'm sure Coach Belichick conveyed that to him when they had conversations that you win the job, you start. If not.
Okay. So I read this yesterday and I sat back and tried to let it compute, let it process. 5 years ago, Cam Newton was the MVP of this league and lifted a 15-1 team into the Super Bowl. He did not play well in the Super Bowl, neither did Peyton Manning.
Right.
In fact, he played better than Peyton, but the Denver defense just took the game over, especially Von Miller. The point is, that man has gone from that, and even a spectacular stretch in 2018 before he hurt his shoulder, to this. He has been relegated to fighting for a starting job with Brian Hoyer, who is now on his 10th NFL stop. He's been to the Patriots three times, but he has changed teams 10 times.
Right.
Think about it. Is that not the ultimate definition of journeyman quarterback?
Well, Skip, that's how it works. You leave your work on good terms, you should always be able to go back.
Brian Hoyer is not bad. He's had his moments.
Yeah.
He's 16-22 as a starter. He had a nice stretch for the Browns 1 year.
Played well in Houston.
Got him in the playoffs.
Yeah.
Started a playoff game. He has 52 touchdowns in his career to 34 interceptions. Not bad.
Right.
He really knows this offense. So I do not doubt that if they do play a couple of preseason games, and I don't know what's going to happen, but whatever, or even in camp practice, I don't doubt that Brian Hoyer will play pretty to very well.
Correct.
Jared Stidham stunk it up his second year at Auburn. He was very good his first year, but he stunk. He lost his way, lost his confidence. He often lost his poise in games, which is why he fell to the fourth round. So the last time I saw him in a competitive situation, he was not great.
Right.
He is going to get an equal shot at winning this job because it appears, by all accounts in New England, Belichick has already developed sort of a soft spot for a kid he calls Stid. Never called Brady any sort of Tommy type.
Yeah, he called him.
But not this. He didn't call him Stid. Okay, so now, Cam Newton. What did I say repeatedly about Cam when he sat on the open market? He was born to be a starter and a star.
Right.
You can't have Cam holding a clipboard. His personality is too big. He has too much pride. Don't do that to him. It's all or nothing with him, and it should have been all with the Chargers out here in Los Angeles. It's like, how can you not take Cam Newton? He's better than Tyrod. I think he's better than that kid out of Oregon they drafted, Justin Herbert.
Skip, if I'm working and all of a sudden I lose my job and nobody's calling, I send out my resume and nobody calling, and nobody calls, and all of a sudden after 3-4 months, a job opportunity comes up, but it's not even a tenth or 1/15 of the pay that I'm normally making. Now, I can sit at home and be prideful. You know what, man? This is beneath my dignity.
Okay, well, it is. This is. But he got his foot back in the door, and he has a chance and the challenge of replacing the GOAT in Foxborough. That's pretty cool. but he's doing it for a base salary of barely over $1 million. Yeah, okay. Patrick Mahomes just got a signing bonus of $63.7
million. $50 million this year.
Woo! Okay? Patrick Mahomes could make $500 million over the next 12 years. Ooh. And Cam is making $1 million, and he's a former MVP. I'm just saying, the optics of it are just staggering to me. I don't get it. It's hard to process that
for me. It's called supply and demand.
Okay, I got it.
One guy was in heavy demand. Other guy wasn't.
So did you watch the video Cam posted? I think it was Sunday on IG.
I did not.
Whoo. He just went off because his pride is killing him, and he has massive pride. And pride that he has earned in the National Football League. We both agreed. He sort of died for the cause in Carolina. He just got beat all to hell by making plays to try to elevate the Carolina Panthers because he can beat you with his physicality as well as with his arm. So in the IG post, he just goes off. It's like he finally just lost it and said, I don't care what anybody says. I'm going to say what I believe. And the first thing he did, he took a shot at Teddy Bridgewater. He said, you're going to choose that over this? And then he said, I am a monster, but I am tired of being humble now. And he went on to say, I'm tired of all this humble SH because when you humble, they start taking advantage of you. Well, Belichick was able to take advantage of his quote-unquote his humbled situation, right? Mm-hmm. And then the final analogy was an animal kingdom analogy. And he talked about all the animals out in the animal kingdom. He said, you got the hyenas, they do what they do, and the elephants do what they do, and the giraffes and the antelopes, the chimpanzees, even the gorillas, they do what they do. But there's one MFing animal in the jungle, and when he roars, everything stops. And you know and I know what he is talking about. And he says, I am about to MFing roar. Okay?
We get a metaphor.
Huh?
We get a metaphor, but theoretically, lions are not in the jungles. That's tigers. Okay. But we get the point where he's making.
Well, that's what he's saying. Okay. I got you. They're out on the Serengeti.
Yes.
Out in the plains. But the point is, when they roar for 10 miles, other animals are like, huh.
You know it.
Huh.
It's unmistakable.
Because that's the one force you cannot defeat.
Right.
And it's hard to even outrun that force.
Right.
Unless you're a gazelle, maybe you got a chance. Right? So the point is, he is flexing all of his considerable muscles because his pride has been battered here, right?
Right.
And he's saying, okay, I'm relegated. I got to go up there. I got to compete with Brian Hoyer and Jared Stidham. It's a three-way battle.
Right.
An equal battle. We all get our chances. Are the reps going to be a third, a third, and a third? I guess so, right?
Yeah.
Whew. So it's come to this for Cam Newton?
Yeah, Skip, I get what Cam's saying, but Cam has to understand. Cam, your stock wasn't that high. You got to rebuild it. Skip, you remember when you rented a car, you basically had, you had Hertz, you had Avis, you had Dollar. Okay, Hertz went bankrupt. They selling for, 10, 90 cents. Google and Apple selling for $300, $400, $500. They're valuable. Cam, there are other teams didn't see the value in you. You have to restore that. You can't get mad at us. Start, and plus another thing, get off social media.
Yeah, I agree.
Because you're reading that, Cam's been humble. You're reading that.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Cam, it ain't what they say, it's what you do.
Yep.
They can call, they can say whatever. I have to tell you, Skip, my grandmother used to tell me all the time. My brother would call me a name. I said, Granny, he called me a name. She said, boy, it ain't what he called you. What you answer to?
I know.
All that other stuff, Cam, is unimportant.
Yep.
If you go be Cam Newton, if you go do what I believe you can do and what you've done the previous year and when you were healthy, and it's a no-brainer.
Okay. I still think Belichick has this master plan, so to speak, of using multiple quarterbacks. He might have a Cam package of plays that work for Cam. He might have Stid plays that are just more.
So where is Brian Hoyer?
I don't know, but Brian Hoyer is probably going to be in this mix.
He got a package too?
Yeah. Well, he might. He might because he's going to be the most accomplished at running this offense.
Right.
You can bet on that.
Right.
But my point is, if Cam Newton does not win any part of this job, if he is just simply the backup quarterback, I don't love this, man.
I don't either.
Woo.
I don't either. But I ain't even worried about it. I don't even think like that. Cam got this one. I ain't even worried about it. Skip. I mean, look, Secretariat, Big Red, that Chestnut Bay coat, it do what it do. He was the best in the field. Right, it wasn't. People like making it seem like it was Ron Turcotte. It wasn't.
No.
It wasn't.
No, Lord, no. I mean, I've never seen anything like that.
No, before. Nobody's ever seen anything like it.
You remember Belmont?
Yes. Whew. 31 and a half length.
Okay.
Now, a little competition is good. I feel like it lights a fire, and we've got some more competition for you.
Uh-uh.
Randy Moss racked up 23 receiving touchdowns.